Hello, good morning students. You are most welcome to class 6th English class. How are you? So, we will study today grammar. I am taking the combined class, class 6th, 7th and 8th, grammar. Okay, grammar. Is it correct? But yes, it's wrong. Grammar is air, not ear. Next question arises. What's the grammar? Write the definition. See the spelling definition, not definition. D-E-F-I-N-I-T-I-O-N. Definition. Wrote down in the any copy. So, a set of rules which enables us to speak and write correct English. This is the definition. A set of rules which enables us to speak and write correct English. A set of rules. Take example. India lives in the villages. That means India is a country of villages. You see, India begins with the capital I because this is grammatical rule. India lives, not live. It is not event. L-E-A-V. No. L-I-V. Why yes? Because subject is third person singular. So it is there in the grammar book. In, not of. Not of, or on, or for, preposition, because it is there in the grammar. Villages, this is the spelling of villages, V-I-L-L-A-G-E, it should not be villages, because in India you find a number of villages. So, now you understood, there is some idea that India lives in villages. Why do you write like this? Because it is according to the grammarians. So third person singular, I will be capitalized. Number one, it is the beginning of the sentence and also it is proper noun. How do you know it is proper noun? How do you know it is common noun? Because everything is there described in the grammar. Then come to, you know, what's the word? Word, W-O-R-D, what's the word? Yes, some children say a group of word, a group of letters which makes some sense is called a word. A group of letters. It's not completely okay because you see, Ram is an intelligent child. Ram is an intelligent child. So Ram is an intelligent child. Ram is a word, is a word, an is a word, intelligent is a word, child is a word. Okay? I have a scooty. How many words are here? Four words. I have, I want, have two, a three, scooty four. Four words. You see, I and a, These are also words, but not a group of a letter. It is one letter. Again, if I write like this,
T C A O O L B B.
Group of words gives no meaning. So, how can you define a word?
C A T.
It will be blood. B L O O D. So, group A letter. Definition of a word is A letter, note down. A letter or a group of letters which makes some sense is called a word. A letter or group of letters which makes some sense is called a word. Then come to sentence. What is a sentence? I am giving you some examples. I have written. So these are not the sentences because it does not give us a complete sense. John A is a farmer. What does it mean? It is meaningless. So answer will be John is a farmer. If you write like this, it will be a complete, it will give you a complete sentence.
He knows me.
Similarly, if you come to the third sentence, there is a in front of a garden, school hour. There is a garden in front of our school. What do we conclude from this? We conclude that a group of words giving us a concrete meaning is called a sentence. Right? A group of words which convey complete meaning is called a sentence. Or a sentence gives us a complete meaning. A group of words which gives us a complete meaning is called a sentence. A group of words which conveys complete meaning is called a sentence. Let us come to the next part, that is forms of sentences, types of sentences. First, declarative sentence. Number one, declarative. D-C-L-A-R-A-T-I-V-E. This is also known as assertive. And assertive sentence again is of two types. One is affirmative or positive and second one is negative. Note down the spelling of affirmative. AFFIRMATTIVE, affirmative. So this is sentence 1, declarative. Sentence 2, interrogative. INTROGATIVE. Third, imperative. IMPRATIVE. Fourth, exclamatory. Fifth, and optative. You might have read in class 5, no. Sixth, emphatic. EMPHATIC. These are the six types of sentences. What is declarative sentence? A sentence which declares something or asserts something, narrates something, is called a declarative sentence. Example will take, he believes in God. He does not, let us say, they do not believe in God. My father is an engineer. Okay. He believes in God. Positive sentence. They do not believe in God. Negative sentence. My father is an engineer. That is positive sentence. What do we conclude from here? All the negative sentences are declarative sentences. All the affirmative sentences are also declarative sentences. But all the declarative sentences are not positive or not negative. Remember it. All the declarative sentences cannot be positive, affirmative or negative. And all the negative sentences can be declarative or assertive. All the affirmative sentences can be declarative or assertive. Now, come to interrogative. Interrogative sentence is that sentence which has something. So, we come to interrogative, no? Example. Interrogative sentence. Where do you live? Like this. Where do you live? So you see, in interrogative sentence, verb precedes the subject. Here, do you see auxiliary verb? Subject is you, it is used before. Subject is you, use knows precedes. Similarly, she is the subject, he is precedes. So this is the interrogative sentence. Again, you remember one thing, interrogative sentences end with interrogation marks of interrogation. Where do you live? If you write live full stop, it will be wrong. So interrogative sentence is that sentence which asks questions. That is interrogative. We can use with who, what, whom, when, where, and the other sentence. Either WH questions or yes, no. Then come to imperative sentence. What is imperative sentence? A sentence which expresses advice, order, request, that is called imperative sentence. Imperative sentence. Example, in imperative sentence, subject is related. It is obvious. It is implied. Shut the door. Shut the door. Come to school on time. Yes, shut the door. So subject is omitted. Come to school on time. Subject is omitted. Subject is implied, obvious. You shut the door. Somebody is giving order. Come to school on time. Order. Submit your homework office. Teacher says to whom? To the students. You submit. Get out. Somebody is giving the order. Yes, you get out. Bring me a glass of water. Somebody is asking somebody to give him a glass of water. So here subject is omitted. So advice, order, request. Please lend me your book for a day. So that is also request. And this is all about imperative sentence. Exclamatory sentence. Next is, note it down, shut the door. Come to school on time. Submit your homework office tomorrow. Get out. Bring me a glass of water. Generally, in imperative sentences, subject is omitted. It ends with full stop. Command, order, advice, request. Obey your elders. This is advice. Then come to exclamatory sentence. A sentence, exclamatory sentence, a sentence which expresses sudden feeling of sorrow, surprise, wonder. Right. A sentence which expresses sudden feeling of sorrow, surprise, wonder is called exclamatory sentence. An exclamatory sentence ends with marks of exclamation. Marks of exclamation. Sometimes it is given at the end of a sentence, or in that sentence the word which expresses that certain feeling of this sorrow, surprise. We will take some examples so that you will have a better understanding. So how blue the sky is. What a beautiful picture. Today we have won the match. Alas, the king is no more. These are the sentences. You see, how blue the sky is. Surprised. How blue the sky is. Exclamation mark is put at the end of a sentence. What a beautiful picture! Exclamation mark is put at the end of a sentence. Hooray! We have won the match. Match ends with full stop. But exclamation mark is given after the word which produces a certain emotion. That is hooray. Hooray is happiness. And feeling of sorrow, surprise, wonder, and also joy will rise. And here joy. Then alas, the key is no more. After more, full stop is given. Alas, sadness, because the king is died. King is no more. Okay? Let's switch over to optative sentence. Optative sentence. What is the optative sentence? Take some examples. Optative sentence. So, may God bless you. Wish you a happy new year. So, you see, all these sentences are optative sentence ends with exclamation mark. Remember, optative sentence ends with exclamation mark. May God bless you. So, wish you a happy new year. Wish you a happy birthday. Best of luck. So you are getting blessings from the seniors. This is you, best of luck because of your examination and like that. So what you mark, what conclusion do you draw from it? That is a sentence which expresses desire, prayer and wish. Desire, prayer and wish is called an optative sentence. An optative sentence ends with exclamation mark like that of your exclamatory sentence. But here it expresses something, that is desire, prayer and wish. Best of luck.